नमस्कार, स्वागत है आप सभी का। आप देख रहे हैं प्रधानमंत्री विद्या चैनल और एनसीईआरटी ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब। मैं हूं आपके साथ धर्मेंद्र सिंह। ये सत्र बड़ा ही कमाल का रहने वाला है, क्योंकि जब हम कमाल की बात करते हैं तो इंटरेस्टिंग सी चीज़ें याद आती है, वो है सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स कक्षा 9 के विद्यार्थियों के लिए। और आज हम जो चीज़ समझने वाले हैं वो टाइटल आपके सामने रख रहा हूँ, लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स पार्ट टू, यानी पार्ट एक हम कर चुके हैं। उसका लिंक भी अवेलेबल है एनसीईआरटी ऑफिशियल के यूट्यूब चैनल पर, आप जाकर उसको देख सकते हैं। आज हम पार्ट टू की बात करेंगे। चलिए, इससे संबंधित अगर आपके प्रश्न हैं तो आप क्या करेंगे, आप कॉल कर सकते हैं हमारे टेलीफोन नंबर पर, देखिए अपने टेलीविजन स्क्रीन पर 8800440559। बिल्कुल अपने प्रश्न यहाँ पर पूछें, जो भी दुविधा आपके मस्तिष्क में हो इस टॉपिक को लेके, और भी संजीदा से प्रश्न जो मैथमेटिक्स या किसी और अन्य बातों से आप परेशान हैं, तो आप ज़रूर कॉल करके पूछा करें। और इसके अलावा आप मेल कर सकते हैं dts.class9@cit.nic.in पर, यह है ऑफिशियल मेल आईडी फॉर क्लास 9 स्टूडेंट। यहाँ पर भी आप अपने सुझाव हमें दे सकते हैं। इस प्रोग्राम से जुड़ने के लिए चैनल नंबर 9 पीएम विद्या का, ये भी आप इससे भी जुड़ सकते हैं। साथ में आप एनसीईआरटी के ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब पर भी इस प्रोग्राम की लाइव कवरेज जो जारी है वहाँ भी आप इसको देख सकते हैं। हमारे साथ जुड़ रही हैं द मदर्स इंटरनेशनल स्कूल नई दिल्ली से मिस दीप्ति माथुर। दीप्ति जी, आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है।
थैंक यू धर्मेंद्र जी, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
तो लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स पार्ट टू की हम बात कर रहे हैं। मैं चाहूंगा कि थोड़ा सा एक रिकैपिचुलेशन एक दो मिनट का हम करके फिर आगे की तरफ जाएं।
जी, सो इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब द लोकेशन ऑफ अ पॉइंट इन अ कार्टेशियन प्लेन, दैट इज टू डायमेंशनल प्लेन। सो दिस इज दिस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड how to describe the location of a point in a Cartesian plane. So now, to understand this better, that is to reinforce the concepts learned in the previous session, let's solve a question. So what is this question is? The plot the points D, E and G and find the coordinates of a point F such that DEFG becomes a rectangle. So let's do this. This will be a quick revision of what we did in the previous session. So now over here, we have plotted the points like this. D is going to be this point, which is -4, 2. All right. As you can see, abscissa of D, point D is -4, ordinate is 2. Then we have D, abscissa is 3 and ordinate is 2. Now, also we have plotted the point G on the Cartesian plane. Now we have to find the point F so that DEFG becomes a rectangle. So the property that we are going to use is that the opposite sides of the rectangle are equal. So opposite sides of rectangle are equal. That means the length of DE will be same as the length of FG. So how do we find the point F? We see the point E, this is the length of the rectangle, and so the perpendicular distance of E is, we can see 3 units away because the abscissa is 3. So that means we are going to find our point somewhere here. Now, how do we get the ordinate of this point? We see the height of the rectangle, that is point G, is the ordinate we see is 5 units away. So it's already 2 units, we will add 3 to it, we will get our, we will be able to locate the point F over here. Let's see this. So we get a rectangle. So we have done the geometrical representation of rectangle on the Cartesian plane. Now you can also see, we can also find the length over here. Length will be abscissa of point E minus the abscissa of point D, that is 3 minus of -4. We can say 7 units will be the length of this rectangle, and the breadth you can already see over here that 5 minus 2 will be the breadth of this rectangle. So see, you can see so conveniently you can find even the area of this rectangle. So let's come to the next thing. I hope you have understood how to identify the fourth point of the rectangle conveniently. Now, also in the previous session, we have discussed examples of linear equations in two variables. We discussed many, many examples, and also the standard form of linear equations in two variables. So we are going to solve one more linear equation in two variables. So let's consider the linear equation in two variables, which is 2x plus 3, 2x plus y is equal to 3. So as we know, we can substitute the value of x and we can find the value of y. We have discussed this, how to find the solutions, and the solutions are going to be ordered pairs. So now substituting for x, we get y. The value of y is going to be 3. Substituting for x is equal to 1, we get the value of y as 1. Substituting for x is equal to 2, we get the y value as minus 1. Same way, if we substitute x is equal to 3, we get the value of y as minus 3. So we have expressed these values in the form of a table, and we write the solutions as ordered pair. Ordered pair also we have discussed. So now we come to do this. Let's have a geometrical representation of these solutions and see what happens. So on a Cartesian plane, all these solutions, x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3, we are plotting. A is equal to, we give it a name, this point as A, and this becomes 0, 3. Point B is 1, 1. And C is here, abscissa is 3, and minus 3 is the ordinate. So 2 points are enough, but we are taking 3 points over here. So now what we do next, let's join these points. So what do we get? We get a straight line. So this is the geometrical representation of the what we have found the solutions algebraically. Now this is the geometrical representation or graph of the linear equation. So one thing which comes in our mind is that why is linear equation called a linear equation? Because its geometrical representation is a straight line. So now, as we know, this line is made up of, has infinite points. So we have to understand that each point on this line is a solution of this linear equation. Now, let's take a point which is not on this line. We will verify, is it a solution of the linear equation, which is 2x plus y is equal to 3? Let's check that. So we see that over here, we take the point 2, 3, which is not lying on the line. So our linear equation is 2x plus y is equal to 3, substituting for x is equal to 2, as abscissa is 2. So we see that the value of y over here is minus 1, and it is not equal to 3, which means this particular point, which is not on the line, this particular point over here, which was not on this line, that is a geometrical representation of 2x plus y is equal to 3, is not the solution of the linear equation 2x plus y is equal to 3. So what do we understand by this? That every point whose coordinates satisfy equation lies on the line AB. Every point AB on the line AB gives the solution x is equal to A, y is equal to B of equation. Any point which does not lie on the line AB is not a solution of the equation. So very clearly, as you can see, that the reason that a degree one polynomial equation AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 is called a linear equation is that its geometrical representation is a straight line. So what do we see here? The connection between algebra and geometry very clearly. Is this clear? So we go ahead, and now we do equations, and identify the equations of lines parallel to the x-axis and y-axis. We should know how do we represent that on a Cartesian plane. So here are some few lines on the Cartesian plane. We see this particular line is parallel to x-axis. We see these two lines are parallel to y-axis. What you observe over here is, whatever may be the value, say for example this one, line which is parallel to x-axis. Now we see that whatever may be the value of y is equal to 2, but whatever may be the value of x, here x is equal to 1, here x is equal to 2, here x is equal to 3, like this, whatever may be the value of x, y is constant, that is y is always equal to 2. So this is such a line is parallel to x-axis. So let's go further. Now you see over here, what do you say about the x-axis? What is the equation of the x-axis? The equation of the x-axis is y is equal to 0, because whatever may be the value of x, y is always equal to 0. Let's do a question to understand this particular concept in a little better way. So solve the equation x is equal to 2 and represent the solution on the number line. And secondly, we will also solve this equation on a Cartesian plane. X is equal to 2. So on a number line, very simple. It is one dimensional number line. And we see this represents x is equal to 2. Now let's represent the equation x is equal to 2 on a Cartesian plane over here. Now x is equal to 2, we can write it as x minus 2 is equal to 0. Now to represent the solution on the Cartesian plane, we can express the equation x is equal to 2 in two variables in the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So we can write x minus 2 is equal to 0 as 1 into x plus 0 into y minus 2 is equal to 0. So what do you say? What is the value of a here? What is the value of b here? What is the value of c? As you can see, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 0, c is equal to minus 2 over here. So we express the solutions of the equation in the form of a table as below. So the value of x is throughout 2, whereas the value of y is 0, 3, 4. So whatever may be the value of y, x is always equal to 2. So let's now put it on the Cartesian plane. Geometrical representation of the equation, that is x is equal to t, x is equal to 2. We see the geometrical representation of x is equal to 2 is a line which is parallel to y-axis, and we have plotted these points. Now from this you can also understand x is equal to minus 4 again will be a line which is parallel to y-axis. So let's solve another question. So we have already done this question as an example in the previous session. So d is equal to 2r. That means the diameter of a circle is twice the radius. So this is an equation. So what do we get to represent the solution on the Cartesian plane? We express it in the standard form. So it becomes d minus 2r plus 0 is equal to 0. The solutions of the above equations are 0, 0, 1, 2, and 2, 4. What have we done? You have already understood that if we substitute the value of r, you will get the value of d. So now we write the solution of the equation in the form of a table. So we take the values of r on x-axis, and we'll take the value of d the y-axis. So what we get over here, this equation we get, what do we have? D is equal to 2r. So the geometrical representation of this equation is also a straight line, and this straight line is passing through the origin. So this kind of equation which is passing through the origin has to be of the form y is equal to mx, where m is a constant. What do you say about m over here? Here, m is equal to 2. So let's do one more question of similar kind. here let's do y is equal to x. So when y is equal to x, we can write the standard form as y minus x plus 0 is equal to 0. So what do we get here? The solutions of the above equations are 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2. Because whatever may be the value of x, y will also have the same value. Any questions so far?
Not so far. If it comes, I will definitely put in front of you. You just keep going, ma'am.
All right. So now we write the solutions of the equation in the form of a table as below. We take the x value and y value for all the values of the abscissa and the ordinate we see over here are same. So let's plot this particular equation. So what do we see here? Check on the line, the red color line, if you can see, this is y is equal to x. So this is again an equation of the form y is equal to mx, and we see we get a straight line. So what can you make out from here? This red color line is y is equal to x, and the blue color line that you can see represents the equation y is equal to 2x. Now both these lines are of the form y is equal to mx, which passes through the origin. So any line of the form y is equal to mx passes through the origin, where m is also called the slope of the line. As you can see, what is an angle this is making? Now you can see that from the x-axis, the red straight line, which is based on the equation y is equal to x, makes an angle. And also this particular straight line, which is y is equal to 2x, also makes some angle. So what we observe is that any line of the form y is equal to mx will always pass through the origin. And m, what you have to remember is m is also called the slope of the line. Now let's do a similar kind of one more question. Draw the graph of the linear equation y is equal to x plus 3. So what we have seen is right now this was y is equal to x, this red straight line that was based on the linear equation, which is the graph of the linear equation y is equal to x. What if we do y is equal to x plus 3? So let's check on that. So when you will substitute the values on the linear equation, y is equal to x plus y, when you substitute the values of x, you will get the values of y. So when x is equal to 0, y is going to be 3. When x is equal to 1, y is equal to 4. When x is equal to minus 3, y will be equal to 0. Y coordinate of the point will be 0. So we write the solutions of the equation in the form of a table as below. These are the values of x coordinate. These are the values of y coordinate. Let's plot it. Now this over here, you see the straight line, which is green color. Why I have put all these lines together now on the same Cartesian plane? So that you can see the difference in them. So now we have y is equal to x plus 3. So now what we see is y is equal to x is this red color line, and this green color straight line represents the linear equation y is equal to x plus 3. Can you make out that both these lines are parallel to each other? So what we observe that all the lines which are of the form y is equal to mx will pass through the origin. And if we say all the lines, equations of the form y is equal to mx plus c, and if we represent it geometrically, will be parallel to, if it is y is equal to x plus 3, it will be parallel to y is equal to x. So basically now we are talking of slopes. We can see that y is, if you actually observe very clearly, then you can see y is equal to x is actually making an angle of 45 degree. So first we connected algebra with geometry, and now we are moving towards trigonometry. So all the topics of mathematics are interconnected, and you can see it so beautifully on a 2D plane, that is Cartesian plane. So let's understand what we have discussed today. Let's summarize. So we have discussed the following points today. An equation of the form AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0, where A, B, C are real numbers, such that A and B are not both 0, is called a linear equation in two variables. A linear equation in two variables has infinitely many, many solutions. The graph of every linear equation in two variables is a straight line. X is equal to 0 is the equation of the y-axis, and y is equal to 0 is the equation of the x-axis. The graph of x is equal to a is a straight line parallel to y-axis. The graph of y is equal to a is a straight line parallel to x-axis. The equation of the type y is equal to mx represents a line passing through the origin. We have also understood every point on the graph of a linear equation in two variables is a solution of the linear equation. Moreover, every solution of the linear equation is a point on the graph of the linear equation. So now, this is how we have summarized. Any point you want to discuss further, we can go back.
Well, Ms. Mathur, because we are talking about mathematics, which is also a very interesting and difficult subject. So whosoever having that dilemma, which is very dangerous and difficult subject, so how we can help them out? Because we are talking about class 9, then the further we will go senior classes like 10th, 11th and 12th. So this dilemma will gonna be bigger. So how we can squeeze these things out from the mind of the students who are, you know, going to towards the subject or the science or any technical kind of subject.
So like we just saw that how we connected algebra with geometry, and now we are moving towards little bit towards other topics also. So maths is nothing but practice. There's no need of fearing about maths. More you practice, more the sums that you practice, listen or attend the classes, and whatever is your teacher telling, take her guidance, and you have to practice maths. That's the only way to take the fear out of your mind.
So I think that's the best time you have, best in the sense that you are not doing you know, too many things, you are at home, so you just keep practicing, keep your you know, efforts put in, so you will definitely get mastered into this. I think this
it
is
has
all
to
you
be
can
written
see.
Practice it has to be written practice, not just looking at it. It has to be written practice, so there will be no fear of mathematics.
Right. So Ms. Mathur, textbook could be the base where you are going to you know, doing practice while doing writing too much. So there are two kind of things. Suppose if I'm taking the help from guide or any other things which have got so many formulas over there, so I don't need to generate too many formulas there, so I can found all the things at the right place. But if we, you know, making the base of textbook, is this going to help you rather than the other resources of the maths going to if you are searching any learning outcomes?
The first step where you should take guidance from, of course, the textbooks are made according, I mean, the textbooks are for the students. Mm-hmm. And first you should master your textbooks. That is very, very important. And then if you are using any other source, then you should take the help of the teacher. That is also going to help you, but that all that should be after your textbooks.
Mm-hmm. Right, but
you
for
should
that
not start from a reference book. Reference books comes after the textbooks. First,
yes,
you should
exactly
master the topic from the textbook, because the concepts you will be thorough with once you are through with your textbooks.
Exactly. So textbook will going to clear your all the concepts, not the reference book. Thank you so much, Ms. Mathur. Quickly, if you have any message, if you would like to deliver to our audience, you may please.
So there is the most important message is there is no need of fearing for mathematics. Mathematics is where you have to practice, and written practice is required in mathematics. And be focused. All of you will do well in mathematics if you practice properly. Wish you all the best.
Absolutely. So on this positive note, we are going to wind up the session. We don't have much more time to continue this. But thank you so much, Ms. Mathur, for your valuable time you have given to our audience. So thank you so much once again.
Thank you so much.
And thank you so much all the viewers for watching this program. But no need to go anywhere, because next program is for class 9 students. Subject is social science, where we'll discuss about poverty as a challenge, part 1. Stay tuned.
Thank you.